It's a disturbing story from right here in New York, where a young child walking home for the first time alone was abducted and then killed by a stranger. There are new details in the investigation and into the suspect, who is now charged with this shocking crime. NBC's Michelle Franzen has more.
The family of Libby Kletsky, the 8-year-old kidnapped and killed after getting lost on his walk home from camp, learned more devastating details this week of how the boy died. The medical examiner's report shows the cause of death was by smothering and intoxication from an acute mixture of drugs.
It brings a kind of closure to a family that has been the victims of this kind of torture.
Prosecutors say at the hands of Levy Aaron, the stranger police say Libby turned to for help and shown here on surveillance tape walking behind him and getting into a car.
We allege that Aaron took Libby to his apartment, where at some point he caused the child to ingest a large number of drugs used to medicate Libby, and then Aaron used a towel to smother the child until he died.
Drugged, murdered, and then dismembered. A grand jury indicted Aaron on 8 counts, including first-degree murder. Aaron faces life without parole and is currently undergoing a psychiatric evaluation. At his arraignment earlier this month, Aaron's lawyer voiced concerns about his client's mental state.
He's indicated to me that he hears voices and there's some hallucinations involved as well.
Gerard Marone, another attorney for Aaron, quit this week, telling the media he could not stomach the brutal crime. In Brooklyn, the close-knit Hasidic community is also struggling to make sense of Libby's death. In a statement, Libby's family says they continue to grieve and the ache in their hearts will remain forever. To honor him, his parents also created a memorial fund in his name. For Today, Michelle Franzen, NBC News, New York.
Authorities reportedly have a confession from the suspect, but what could they be looking for inside his home? With us now is criminologist, attorney, and contributor to True TV's In Session, Casey Jordan. Good morning.
Good morning.
And let's begin with some of this evidence that police have been seen taking out of Levy Aaron's home. What are they collecting at this point?
Well, what they describe is a sizable quantity of children's clothing, as well as a few other items that would be described as children's blanket, I think a cup, a bowl, but it's the clothing, I think, that were probably...
Kids' pants was what was
right.
labeled on one of the bags.
Exactly.
What's your reaction to that discovery?
Well, one of two or even three things. And the number one thing the police are looking at is, are these remnants or souvenirs from other children who have been in his home and who may have, they have to consider this, suffered the same demise as little Libby. The other thing they would look at is, are these things he's put in his home in anticipation of bringing children there? Are they there in case he ever kidnapped or wanted to keep a child as his own? Or are they items, especially when you think about the blanket, the bowl, the cup, are they items that are meant to groom a child, to win the trust, to make a child feel comfortable in his home so that he could do them harm?
Now, in terms of what happened to this little boy while he was there, there are reports that Aaron simply kept him there and then killed him out of panic when he realized that there was a massive search underway. Do you buy that?
I have to tell you, if that is how it worked, it would be extremely rare that this child was not assaulted or sexually abused in the process. But I don't want to rule it out. Keep in mind that just because the police and the autopsy are not releasing any details of sexual abuse doesn't mean it
right.
didn't happen. At the same time, this man clearly suffers from mental illness. He had drugs for psychosis in his home. So you do wonder if he's just mentally ill, kept the child, and did kill him.
And speaking of drugs, because part of that was actually found in a little Libby's system, he had a mix of drugs actually found in his blood. The medical examiner found a muscle relaxant, a pain medication, Tylenol, and that antipsychotic drug.
Right.
What are the presence of these drugs allegedly administered by Aaron say about the process in which this little boy died and what his thought process was in doing so?
Again, we don't typically see this in criminology. Usually these crimes are sexually motivated. But this man, even in his confession, said, I think I may have done something wrong. He seems even unsure that killing the child was a wrong thing to do. We know, of course, his defense is going to be reaching for an insanity defense. If he was indeed on medication, had a history of psychosis, they will certainly attribute this horrific tragedy to that mental illness.
And Casey, seeing how we've seen police investigators bringing out these bags of evidence, and we see some of the details of this crime unfolding, and now we know they're digging in his backyard. Is it safe to assume they're looking for other victims potentially?
Yes, they are. I'm sure that is the thought process. They can't rule anything out. There are reports in the community that Mr. Aaron may have tried to lure a child into his car just a few weeks ago, so they can't rule anything out. I'm sure they're looking at all the missing children in the area and have to consider whether or not this is not the first time Mr. Aaron has done this.
All right, Casey Jordan, thanks so much. We appreciate it.
Great to be here.